With us in the studio is my favorite son-in-law, our life insurance specialist here at Tony Walker Financial, Trey Jurgens. Trey, how are you doing this morning?
I'm good. How are you? Thanks for having me.
I've been looking forward to this. Now, we've had more and more questions and some really favorable comments about this whole notion of what we call 10-pay life insurance. Let me point to this. You know, these are the five things, folks, that we talk about that first halfers should consider. So we're talking about number two. That's all we're talking about with Trey. And, you know, we were talking before we came on, Trey. Everybody wants to pay off their house early, and I'm all for that. And we often talk about, why does people not want to pay off their life insurance early? You're going to eventually die. Why wouldn't you want to get all your money back tax-free and leave it to kids? So you've got a great concept to share. It's called the 10-pay life insurance policy.
Yeah, so on a recent webinar, we covered three types of life insurance, the last one being whole life. We highlighted a 10-pay whole life insurance policy, which, in essence, you pay for only 10 years. So you kind of combine the payments into those 10 years.
Kind of like paying off your home.
Exactly. Right? So 15-year mortgage versus 30, you're kind of paying up front and not taking those premium payments into retirement.
So we took a 35-year-old, just in this example, one of our companies, preferred female, meaning they're in good health, no nicotine use. All this factors in, and Trey can get you an illustration if you want to look at your situation. But let's go over these numbers. Pretty fascinating, Trey.
Yeah, so in a 10-pay for a 35-year-old female, again, this is no tobacco use, what she's considered doing is paying $500 a month, so $6,000 annual premium. And reminder, it's just for 10 years. So after 10 years, she's invested $60,000 into this policy.
But no more premiums are due now, the rest of her life.
She's done. She's paid
guaranteed,
up.
Guaranteed, folks. Let me use that word. It's done. All right, go ahead.
Exactly. So after that 10 years, the cash value, the net cash value, assuming current dividends, is almost what she's put into it, which is $58,989.
So really no risk or anything like that. No taxes have had to been paid. No, not a bunch of fees. Go ahead.
So that first year, immediately, the death benefit is $195,000. So that's only at $500 a month. After the 10 years, she's done paying. That's grown to $222,506.
So contrary to what people like to say about life insurance not growing, if you have the right type of overfunded policies, it'll keep growing as well as the dividends are paid, correct?
Exactly.
So let's fast forward now to 65. What happens, knowing again that this person has not paid any more premiums, current dividends? Oh, by the way, one of the companies we use, I thought this was so cool. They have paid a dividend on their life insurance contracts consecutively for 115 years, and I thought, I keep forgetting, these products have been around forever. They have truly stood the test of time, haven't they?
Pretty healthy institutions.
Yeah, they are. Go ahead, at 65.
Yeah, so fast forward to 65. She hasn't paid a premium in 20 years at that point, and the policy's grown to $141,000 of cash value, and that's something she can borrow, get her hands on, and death benefit at that point is $288,000, almost $289,000.